இத்திஹாச புராணாத்யாம் வேதம் சௌபபிரம்மயேத் பிபேத்யல்பஸ்ருதாத் வேதா மாமயம் பிரதரிஷ்யதி நிகம கல்பதரோர் கலிதம் பலம் சுகமுகாத் அமிர்தத்ரவ சயுதம் பிபத பாகவதம் ரசமாலயம் முகுரஹோ ரசிகா புவி பவுகா. த பாடி அண்ட் ஆத்மா, த அச்சேதனா அண்ட் சேத்தனா ஆர் த பாடி ஆஃப் பரமாத்மா. But this Achetana cannot realize that he is my Atman and serve him. Whereas Atma can realize that he is my Antaratman and serve him. Our Acharyas are so concerned that unfortunately, equal to Achetana, this Chetana also does not realize this. What to do now? We are superior, we are considered superior because we have the knowledge. We have that privilege to recognize Paramatma as my Antaratma. But if I forego my privilege and say, I am quite happy being equal to Achetana, what will happen? We should not be equal to Achetana. There was a Sribhashya Kalakshepam. It was for 1 year. The Acharya was leaving back home. All the Shishyas came to bid him a farewell. It was a train railway station. Acharya was just leaving. Unfortunately, he had to put a question to his Shishyas. He asked them, now I tried my best to preach you. It was a 1 year course. Have you all understood? Do you all now know what Sri Bhashyam Brahma Sutram says? One Shishya just tapped the earth. What does it mean? Whatever earth would have understood, I understood equally. Acharya said, it is right that the earth would not have understood because it is insentient. Whereas you cannot say so, you are sentient. Being sentient, let us not waste. That is the preaching of all our Acharyas. Now both are Sharira, Achetana and Chetana, or the Sharira of Paramatma. Achetana cannot realize that Paramatma is his Antaratma, whereas Atma can realize that Paramatma is my Antaratma. If you realize, how would you conduct yourself? The Sharira acts as per my wishes. As a Sharira, I must act as per the wishes of Paramatma, because I am his part now. So whatever he thinks, I must do. Now assume for a moment, this body does not respond to me. What does it mean? It means there is a disease. If this body does not respond to me, it's a problem, it's a nervous disorder. Similarly, if Atmans do not respond to the call of Paramatma, it's a disorder, it's a big disease. But we think that we are quite okay. We are not okay. You are all diseased, you are all patients. Why don't you now get cured yourself? Alvar in one Pasharam says, முன்னீர் ஞாலம் படைத்த என் முகில் வண்ணனே அன்னாள் நீ தந்த ஆக்கையின் வழி உழல்வேன். முன்னீர் ஞாலம் படைத்த என் முகில் வண்ணனே, யூ கிரியேட்டட் திஸ் யூனிவர்ஸ் ஃபார் வாட்? ஃபார் யூ டு பி த பெனிஃபிஷியரி. முன்னீர் ஞாலம் படைத்த என் முகில் வண்ணனே அன்னாள் நீ தந்த ஆக்கையின் வழி உழல்வேன். பகவான் பிளஸ்டஸ் வித் திஸ் பாடி. டு டூ வாட்? யூஸ் திஸ் பாடி டு சர்வ் ஹிம். Put this body to its rights purpose of creation. But what I did was, instead of using this body to his purpose, I used this body to my purpose. Instead of acting as per his guidance, I started acting as per the wants of this body. If this body wanted physical comfort, I gave it to him, did not fast on an Ekadashi day. Because I wanted a physical comfort, I have acted as per the wish of this body, not as per the wish of Paramatma. So this is where there is a contradiction. Then this contradiction becomes an internal conflict, because I was created for his benefit, I don't act to his benefit, then there is a conflict with creation itself. When there is a conflict with the very creation, the product is getting wasted, the product would get rusted. I must use the product for its right purpose. We created pen to write. If I use it to remove dirt from my ears, I can. Dirt would be removed, but for once. The next day, the pen won't write, neither I can hear the next day. So both, I lost both because I have put it to the wrong purpose. The purpose of creation for a pen is to write. Don't use it differently. Ade Mari, the purpose of creation to this Atman and this body is to serve him. There is a purpose for that. That's with the purpose which he created. If I do not go by that. So we have dealt about Chit, Achit and Ishvara, the nature of association between Chit, Achit and Ishvara, the behavior, the constant change, Swarupa Vikara, Rupa Vikara, Guna Vikara, about Chit, Achit and Ishvara, These are the fundamentals of creation. Now, after dealing with these fundamentals, now let us go to the purpose of creation. The purpose of creation is, there are two. One, purpose for Brahman, and the other, purpose for Jivatma. There are purposes for Brahman as well as Jivatma out of creation. What is the purpose for Brahman? He is already there, all accomplished. If I am not accomplished, then I have a purpose to live. Brahman is all accomplished. Then what is that purpose? Purpose of Brahman is Leela. I am going to be pretty blunt now. Leela. Lokavattu Leela Kaivalyam. Why does he create? Why does he sustain? Why does he absorb? Srishti, Sthiti, Samharam. All these three are his Leela. Are his pastimes. Before I can conclude, I know that you are going to jump with the question. The question is, am I a pawn to his Leela? He can do whatever Leela he wants, but he cannot swing the stick and hurt me. And why should I become a part of his Leela? Why should I be a pawn? I will not be. You need not be. And his Leela is not something that will offend anybody. His Leela is so glorious that as a byproduct, many get benefited. For example, a Leela, a sport, a game. I create a game. I build a big maidan. I build a ground. I build all infrastructure. I call many people. I allow them to play. I give them gifts. I give them salary. If I do, is it going to hurt anyone? Not. Many get employment and many get benefited. Similarly, by the game of Srishti, Sthiti, Samharan, many Atmans benefit. What is that benefit? We have to understand that in the right perspective. For Brahman, it's a Leela pastime, because Brahma Sutra Vedavyasa says, Lokavattu Leela Kaivalyam. I am quoting all the important messages, all the important passages from your Pramana. It's very important that we can't talk in the air. It must have been well confirmed by a Pramana. Lokavattu Leela Kaivalyam. Leela Kaivalyam. Leela, Kevala Leela. This entire process of creation and destruction is only for as a pastime. The name Deva is an epithet. Because Divuk Krida, one who plays, one who has lot of pastimes, is named as Deva. Varuna is a Deva, Vayu is a Deva, Surya is Deva. Whereas Bhagavan is known as Deva Deva. As his pastime is creating these Devas. These Devas have different pastimes. But Brahman's pastime is even to create these Devas. So he is known as Mahadeva or Deva Deva or Deveshwara. Deva, Divuk Krida, one who has a pastime, a Leela. So the most important purpose of creation is Leela. As he is an ocean of compassion. Now you see how it all happens. It's an incidental happening. It's not the main happening. Whereas incidentally, he is also an ocean of compassion. Fortunately, because if a person wants to have lot of pastime but is wicked, you know what would happen? If a person wants to have lot of good pastimes and is an ocean of compassion, what would happen? That makes the difference. If I am really powerful but I am wicked, I become Ravana. If I am really powerful, I become pious, I become Hanuman. That's where the difference lies. It's the same power. The power added to wickedness makes a Ravana. The power added to piety makes Hanuman. So we need to decide whether we would like to be a Ravana or a Hanuman. You can be very powerful. At the same time, be polite. You can be quite pious. Now, Bhagavan, if I can say so, he is a benevolent dictator. He is a dictator and never accepts democracy, no referendum. But he is a benevolent dictator. Ocean of compassion, so the Jiva benefits incidentally through his pastime. Bhagavan's pastime is creation. As a byproduct, the Jiva benefits out of that creation. Because when he creates, it's not that he creates his mundane objects. What does he do? He blesses us with a body. What will I do with this body? I can practice karma yoga, jnana yoga, bhakti yoga and liberate myself from the cycles of birth and death. That is what Bhagavan wants to happen. If I know this subtle aspect, then I stand to gain. If I forget that, if I turn a blind eye to the simple aspect, I am born, born and dead again and again. This continues forever. So the jiva benefits incidentally through his pastime. Yogapatyam anugrahakaryam. Yogapatyam, creation, is a product of Bhagavan's mercy. Anugrahakaryam. Anugraham is daya. Anukampa, karuna. And he takes pity. He showers his mercy on all the jivatma when he starts creation. Why? I see someone who is hurt. Then my mercy sprouts. I immediately want to help him. I rush to help him. Now Bhagavan looks at us. During the deluge, deluge is all the pralaya. During pralaya, where do we all dwell? We have to live somewhere. All this won't be there. No America, no India, no London, nothing. Nothing would be there, not even Prithivi, Appu, Tejasu, Vayu, Akasha. Even the primordial element of creation would have vanished. Everything would be Brahman, Brahman and Brahman. At that time, what would I be? I would be lying by the side of Achetana. Achetana and Chetana, even during Samhara, would be in inseparable association with Brahman. That will never change. Whether it is Samhara or Srishti, Brahman will always be Vishishtam. This Chetana and Achetana will be inseparable with Brahman. Then what happens during Srishti? During Pralaya, we are all inseparable. After Srishti, again we are all inseparable. It would have been better if I show pictorially to you. This Chetana and Achetana are inseparable with Brahman during Pralaya. Again this Chetana and Chetana are inseparable with Brahman even after creation. Then where is the difference? There has to be a difference between the deluge and creation. The difference is, Brahman remains the same. He will not undergo any change. Instead, the Chetana and Chetana would be in their subtle form, transferred to their gross form. That only would have changed. What is the difference between subtle form and a gross form? When something has no name or form, it is subtle form. If it is a name and form, it is a gross form. It is known as Nama, Rupa, Vibhaga, Arhatva and Anarhatva. Nama, Rupa. Nama is name. Rupa is form. During Pralaya, none of us will have any name or Rupa. Not name, not any form. Now this Srishti, there is a name. Now, when you put a venue, immediately you call by a name. There is a place. This is the state. This is the city. This is a town. This is a county. And this is the country. And there are so many galaxies. So everything has a form, a particular identifiable name. Whenever there is a name and form, it's in its gross status. Whenever there is no name or form, it's in the subtle nature. So during Pralaya, everything will be subtly in association with Brahman. And after creation, we are all again in association with Brahman in our gross form. So this is where it makes the difference. Bhagavan, Yogapatyam Anugrahakaryam. Bhagavan's effect of compassion is creation. Anugrahakaryam. Akhila Bhuvana Janma, Stema Bhangadi Lile, Vinada Vivida Bhuta, Vrata Rakshayika Drikshe, Shuti Shirasi Vidipte, Brahmani Srinivase, Bhavatumama Paraspin, Shemushi Bhakti Ruva. Bhagavad Ramanuja, in his glorious work Shri Bhashya, the invocatory versus this. Akhila Bhuvana Janma Stema Bhanga Adi Lile. Janma Stema Bhanga. Janma creation. Stema sustenance. Stema Bhanga destruction absorption. Now I will also clarify here. Nothing is destroyed. I already told you all the three real entities are Nitya. They cannot be totally destroyed. Then what does this Samhara mean? There is a term, Samhara, Samhara, destruction, destruction. It is not destruction. It is only absorption. Bhagavan creates everything and absorbs everything back into him. If he destroys, first it's not possible. Nothing is destructible. Only it is transformable. Things can change but can never be destroyed. So, Akhila, Bhuvana Janma, Stema Bhangadi Lile, Vinada Vivida Bhuta Vrata Rakshayika Dikshe. Bhagavan takes pity on us during this deluge. Here, a Jivatman who can go to a temple, who can perform puja, who can read texts, who can meditate on me, who can help others, who is so great, equivalent to me in all his power. Unfortunately, he is just lying by the side of this Achit, as equal to an Achit, as a mundane object Why not I resurrect him? Why not I add some energy to him? He has everything, but he needs to be created. Not created in the real sense, because Atma can never be created. His here creation would mean allowing him to take birth with a body. That's the creation. So Brahman takes that decision during deluge. Atma loses his identity and lies abandoned, equal to Achit. This is the very pitiable state, but we don't recognize this at all. If you treat yourself equal to Achetana, then there is no concern, no fear, nothing. You are so happy, you can sleep. But that's not the right state. I can be. If a child is born, at the age of 1 he has to speak, age of 2 he has to crawl, age of 3 he has to walk. But it was good that the child was under my absolute control when he was 6 months old. Now if he gets older, he will think on his own ways, he won't be under my control. So will the mother decide, let the child ever be under my absolute control, let him not talk, let him not crawl, let him not walk, let him not grow at all? No, no. The child has to grow, he has to learn, he has to know the right values of life and be under my control. He has to choose to be under my control. I won't compel him to be under my control. Whereas he must go around, see this world, see all the problems of this world, come back running to his mother and say, oh mother, you are my controller. This is what the mother expects. Whenever you take the jatagam of your daughter or son, you know that we invite problem. We do invite. But in what is the expectation of a mother? My son should get married. My daughter-in-law must come to me and accept my supremacy. Instead, why not this solution? Don't get him married at all. No mother will accept. Similarly, you may say, you may have a doubt that why should I be created? During the big deluge, I had no concern, no fear, no problem, because I didn't have anything to think. I was just equal to Achetana. Can you continue so? There will be a school of thought which advocates, yes, it would have been better if I was in pralaya. It is not so. It is like if you want to shed weight, can you fast forever? It's easy. You fast for 15 days, lose weight. You can't even walk. You can't read. Can't do anything. So you have to eat, exercise and burn calories. There is no other go now. You have to eat first to shed weight. Is it not contrary? To shed weight, I must fast. Whereas we all say, eat the right way. Eat optimum and work out. Similarly, Bhagavan also thinks, making him fast is not the right solution. Instead, make him re-eat. That eating is srishti. He is given birth and he has to eat the right content, the right quantity, the right quality, and has to exercise. What are those? Practicing karma yoga, jnana yoga, bhakti yoga and reaching him. This was the expectation of Paramatma when he created. Unfortunately, we are so intelligent to defeat even his expectation. Omnipresent, omniscient, Brahman decides to give a body to this jiva to perform yoga and attain salvation. So we have seen the purposes of both. Brahman has a purpose, Leela. Jiva has a purpose to get liberated. So these are the purposes of Brahman and Jivatma. For a jiva and Brahman. Now let us come back. Karanam tu dhyaya. Whichever is the karanam of this world, meditate on him. Meditating on him, what is the benefit? I get released from the bondage. So to get released, dhyana, meditation on the karana, to have that meditation, establish that karana, establishing karanatvam is the process of creation. If you know why I am created and who is my creator, then I know by the karana. Dhyaya, dhyana and karana, meditation on the cause is the means for salvation. So it is important to know the jagat karana Brahman and the purpose of our creation. I have told you the purpose. Bhagavan took pity on us, wanting us to get liberated and reach his lotus feet, blessed with karana and kalebara. Please know these two words. Karana, all our limbs, our indriyas. Kalebara, body. So don't ever blame Bhagavan that he created you. Yes, he did. He did do it out of mercy. He was a compassion, ocean of compassion, so he created me. And if I don't realize the purpose, then the creation itself is wasted. But again and again, Bhagavan creates, relentless. He is never frustrated. Why does he do? And this is one quality which we must all learn from Brahma. You must be relentless in achieving your goal. Come what may, whatever may be the opposition to it, or whatever may be people may even ridicule you, do not worry. Create. Do. Similarly, when we start learning, whatever may be the hurdle, start, continue till you achieve your goal. To achieve the goal Bhagavan creates, to achieve the goal of Bhagavan's creation, we have to perform Bhakti Yoga and Prapatti. This is the purpose of creation. Now let me tell you about the process of creation. Then we will deal about the problem in creation. First is the purpose. Second is the process of creation. Brahman is Vishishtam, inseparably associated with Chit and Achit. I have already explained to you about that. As body and soul, as Shariratma Bhava. Next, without undergoing a transformation of the self, Brahman cannot become a Karana. A clay has to undergo a transformation. Cotton has to transform to become a sari. So, this is a prerequisite. Transformation is a prerequisite for anyone to be a material cause. Now tell me, should the potter change to make a pot? Should a weaver change to make a sari? Should a goldsmith change to make a chain? No need at all. The gold has to change. Clay has to change. Iron has to change. Cotton has to change. Oh, this potter is also a cause. The clay is also a cause. It seems that the clay has to change. Potter need not change. Why is it so? Whenever there is a cause, it has to change to become a product. There is mud. It has to change. There is a potter who never changes. Now, the question is, these two are different causes. They are not one and the same cause. To make any product, you need three different causes. One cause is the material cause, that is the mud to the pot, clay to the pot, or cotton to the sari. The second is the instrumental cause, the one who decides that I will create this product. He is the instrumental cause. Second. Thirdly, although there is an instrument, although there is a material, can a sari be made? It's not possible. You need a loom. And it can be a manual loom or a power loom. Let it be. There has to be a tool with which we achieve it. So that is the third cause. Now these three causes are termed in Sanskrit as Upadana Karana, Nimitta Karana and Sahakari Karana.